At the time of recording today, we're all in lockdown, so thank you to everyone who's staying at home helping their local health service in the country you're in. Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to talk about Microsoft 365 and Office 365. Confused? You should be. Microsoft have changed the names, the products may not be the same as what you think they are, and we're going to clear all the confusion. So stay tuned. Now, on the 21st of April in the UK, can't guarantee every country, Microsoft Office 365 is becoming Microsoft 365. So they're taking out the word office. Now, what does it mean for you? Currently means nothing. Simple answer, it means nothing. Now, there's three main products that are advertised on Microsoft's website that many of you will be using. Office 365 Business Essentials. This is the online version of Office 365. So Word Online, Excel Online, PowerPoint Online, Exchange Online, which is sending and receiving email, SharePoint Online, storing files, saving files up online to the cloud, Teams, so that you can have communication with your colleagues via video, chat, audio calls. There is also Office 365 Business. Now, that is just basically the Office software on your computer, but on a subscription model. So, where you would have had Office 2016 or 2019, it means that you're paying for this on a subscription. But the benefit is you're staying up to date with the version of Office you're using. So that Office 365 Business is the software locally, whereas Office 365 Business Essentials is the software online only. And then the other one is Office 365 Business Premium. Now, this is both of what I've just explained. So, the online version of Office and the online tools, Exchange for email, SharePoint for file storage, Teams, etc. So, that's the business essentials covered. And then the Office software constantly being updated, which is a separate product, Office 365 Business. So Business Premium is combining Business Essentials and Business. They're the three main products that are used. Now, Microsoft are changing the names to Microsoft 365 instead of Office 365 at the end of April 2020. So the date, I believe, is the 21st of April. This could change, but their communications this week has been confirming the 21st of April, and we will put a link in the description below where you can see the comparisons of these products. Likewise, we're going to pause this video and show a table firstly of the name changes. So what it was, what it is, should we say, to what it will be. To continue, so these name changes effectively start on the 21st of April. And what Microsoft is pushing towards now is cloud security. So on their website, which you'll see a link below, I'm going to attach another screenshot to this video. And while you're looking at this screen, basically what you're seeing is that Microsoft are promoting the Office 365 Business Essentials, the Microsoft Office 365 Business Premium, and then the added-on service with the cloud security. So this is an extra layer of security that you may or may not wish to proceed with for your business. Now, I'm not going to push you towards any of these products, but generally, Business Essentials and Business Premium are the products that companies tend to purchase, and the other products are geared towards larger enterprises. So 500, 1,000, etc., staff, and so on. So if that's what you're looking for, those additional secure levels of security would be where you'd go. Now, as a small business, budgets are tight, and the Business Essentials, Office 365 Business Essentials, which is what I'm going to refer it in this video, and Office 365 Business Premium tend to be the two products that small businesses are utilizing, so that they've got the online storage with OneDrive and SharePoint, which will include a link to a video explaining that further. The SharePoint storage, so shared storage, Microsoft Teams, collaborating, so whether you're using Skype, Zoom, GoToMeeting, Teams is an extension to Skype and Skype for Business. We've got a video on this as well. Sorry. And we've already mentioned SharePoint. So to summarize, Microsoft 365 is essentially Office 365. The names have changed. The pricing has not. So over the coming months, you're going to start seeing your Office software, instead of saying Office 365, it will start saying Microsoft 365. Instead of the online portal, it will start saying Microsoft 365. And when you receive your receipts, invoices from Microsoft, you're going to see it say Microsoft 365, not Office 365. So to clarify the confusion, it's basically a name change. The product hasn't changed. And if you knew what it was previously, just check back earlier in this video with a screenshot showing you what it was called and what it now will be called, so that you understand now it's called this name. There are another two products that Microsoft also promote, but as they're not core products that we're seeing businesses go towards, I haven't discussed it in this video. But if you would like them discussed, comment below and we will add a future video explaining them in further detail. If you thought this video was helpful, please give us a like and subscribe, as we've got a lot of content on Office 365, which, as you know, now will be called Microsoft 365. So it's the same thing. Check out the other videos on Office 365 and Microsoft 365. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Stay safe, stay well, and hopefully this lockdown will end soon.